Hello everyone, and welcome to our Unite Now session on building spatial AR applications with Vuforia Engine in Unity. My name is Brad Pitzer, and I'm the Director of Augmented Reality for Vuforia Engine at PTC. In this session, I'll be covering the value of spatial augmented reality, and later I'll be joined by one of my colleagues who'll show you how to build an application with one of our most innovative features to date called Area Targets. So let's get started.
Vuforia Engine launched Area Targets in March of 2020. This unique spatial augmented reality technology allows you to use a digital twin of the world around you to view digital content in the context in the environment. That means attaching any kind of augmented information to anything and everything in the space you're in. The possibilities are endless, from spatial navigation to IoT data to spatially aware instructions to games and more. Areas like museums, retail stores, offices, factory floors are all ideal environments for area targets. In our session today, we're going to walk through what area targets are and why they can be invaluable to your application. We will discuss the what, where, when, and why of how you would use area targets in your large spaces, including how to make them. I will also give you a demonstration of a new app that we just released called the Area Target Creator that uses your LiDAR scanner-enabled phone or tablet to display, scan, and create an area target from the space around you. Then I'll be passing it over to one of our senior AR engineers, Jake Steinerman, to show you how to build an area target application in Unity. Vuforia Engine Area Targets enable customers to recognize and track to an entire space, be it a factory or a museum, for a unique augmented reality experience. Using a supported commercial scanner or our Area Target Creator app on your device, developers can create detailed 3D models of a desired location. From this digital twin of your space, we can build an area target with Vuforia Area Target Generator, which can later be brought into Unity where you can create a fully interactive AR application. So why is spatial AR so valuable? What makes it so different than any other AR feature available today? The spaces where we live, work, and shop have an abundance of valuable information, but it can be difficult to access relevant data in its true context. Many augmented reality applications today rely on object or image-based tracking, which is limited to having the subject in view and is not designed for large immersive experiences. Most AR platform providers also offer ground plane tracking, which offers the ability to place 3D objects on flat surfaces, but their placement is arbitrary and without context to a specific location. Area targets offer the ability to create immersive, persistent spatial AR experiences that are completely coupled to an environment. Using the space itself as the target, with 3D augmentations connected directly to the environment, people can view relevant information contextually. This can be incredibly valuable for a variety of different locations for creating dynamic navigation, viewing real-time data about the space, or even placing promotional experiences in the setting of your location. As I mentioned earlier, there are a variety of different spaces where area targets can bring value. Some of the more ideal locations and applications where we are seeing developers build amazing experiences are in museums, offices, factories, retail stores, hotels, and airports. Just like in the case of locations, there are hundreds of different ways you can create area target powered applications. Two of the most powerful use cases are in-context information and guided navigation. In an industrial use case, you can attach digital content like real-time IoT data, images, and videos to your factory floor to give better context to the frontline workers. Or in the case of an office building, you can create navigation experiences to help guide employees or visitors through your building, showing them room numbers, people's offices, booking conference rooms, and even control the room's environmental settings, such as lighting and air temperature. We recently released the Vuforia Area Target Creator application, which allows developers to easily generate an area target of a small space using depth-enabled mobile devices, such as the new iPads and iPhones with LiDAR scanners. The Vuforia Area Target Creator also enables users to test tracking and the stability of the same area targets in their corresponding environments before developing content. This app is a great way to introduce you to area targets and allow you to see the incredible value that it can bring to your applications. Let's walk through a quick demonstration. When you create an area target, you'll be prompted to log in with your Vuforia developer credentials. You must have internet connection to do this. You can open an existing area target by pressing the container button, but to create an area target from scratch, press the plus button and a new window will prompt you to name your area target. Once you've named your area target, then hit start scan. The app will prompt you to slowly move around the room and capture the room with your mobile device, scanning up and down to capture the space. Like painting a wall, you will see a colorful mesh on the surfaces captured while you scan. Note that the timer is also started on the right side of the screen, which will inform you of the available scanning time in minutes. If you hit the 3-minute marker, the scanning process automatically finishes and you'll be prompted to either save or discard your scan. When you are finished scanning, press the stop button. If you're happy with your scan, press generate and the Vuforia Area Target Creator will generate an area target database. Now I can test this area target by selecting the container button and loading the area target that I just created. So I will load the area target I just made and begin moving through the space I just scanned. You will see a successful area target when you see white lines delineating the geometry and objects in the space. This means the space has been recognized and is tracking good. This area target database can be transferred to your computer as well and loaded into Unity so you can start authoring your spatial AR application. So now that we've talked about the value and uses for area targets and how to create a new area target with our Area Target Creator application, I'm going to hand things off to my colleague, Jake, who will walk you through the process of creating an area target AR experience in Unity from a scan taken from a commercial 3D scanner.
Thanks, Brad. Hi, Unity developers. My name is Jake Steinerman, and I'm a senior augmented reality engineer with PTC. In the second half of this session, I'm going to walk you through how to go and create an area targets experience in Unity. Then, at the end of the session, you're going to see how an area targets application built in Unity all comes together.
Now, let's go over what you're going to need. First, the Vuforia Engine SDK versions 9.0 or higher, the Vuforia Engine Area Target Generator, a commercially supported 3D scanner or depth-enabled mobile device, the latest version of the Unity 3D Editor, and of course, a space you're going to want to augment. In its initial 9.0 release, Area Targets supports environments of up to 1,000 square meters, around 10,000 square feet. We're continuing to update the size of spaces that we support, so keep an eye on the Vuforia developer portal for future updates. Vuforia Engine Area Targets require the use of a supported 3D scanner. Our current list of supported devices and best practices can be found on the Vuforia developer portal. The team is actively working on expanding our 3D scanner support for future releases, but if there are any other 3D scanners you'd want to see supported in the future, let our team know in the developer forums. So there's 4 steps to creating an area target experience. First is creating a scan of your space. Second, generating an area targets database using the area target generator. Third, importing the area target into Unity. And last, but not least, is building and testing your experience. So let's get started. In order to create a Vuforia Engine area target, you're going to need a 3D scan of your desired environment. We're not going to be going into the steps and best practices for creating a 3D scan, since each scanner has different requirements. Be sure to check out our developer portal for more information. Once you've completed your scan and acquired the 3D model of your room, open the Area Target Generator, which you can download from the Download Tools section of the Vuforia Developer Portal. Then, log in with your Vuforia Developer credentials. In this example, we're using a Matterport Pro 2 camera, and in order to bring your scan space into the Area Target Generator, you're going to need to enter your Matterport API keys and enter the space ID. As we continue to add more supported 3D scanners, the process for creating an area target is going to change a little bit. Once all the information has been entered, click create area target. Then you'll see how many area targets you have remaining in your account and where your targets are going to be saved. The free Vuforia developer license starts with a quota of 10 area targets, but a VIP or pro license will allow you to generate unlimited area targets. Next, click continue. Then you'll see a log output about the downloading, processing, and generation of the area target during the creation process. If you wish, you can stop the process by pressing cancel. Once the process is done, an OK button is going to become available. By pressing it, you'll get returned to the home screen. Your area target dataset is available in the folder you selected at the beginning of the process, and it's ready to be imported into the Unity Editor. Open a new or existing Unity project and be sure to set it up with Vuforia Engine. Then, remove the main camera from the scene and replace it with a Vuforia Engine AR camera object. Obtain a license key from the Vuforia Developer Portal and place it in the License Key field under Vuforia Configuration in the AR Camera dropdown. Be sure to enable Device Tracker at the same time. Just a note, you can get a free developer license key under the Develop tab when you're logged into the Vuforia Engine Developer Portal. If you want to publish your app to an app store for commercial or internal use, you can find the link to our pricing options on the Vuforia Developer Portal. After the license key has been added, create an Area Target Game Object from the Game Object drop-down menu under Vuforia Engine, and then select Area Target. You can import the Area Target Database Unity package that was generated in the Area Target Generator by selecting Assets, Import Package, Custom Package. In the Inspector window of the Area Target Game Object, choose the Imported Database and Area Target via the drop-down menu. Now it's time to configure your area target. The area target database contains additional assets of the scanned area, including textures, materials, and a prefab model. After importing the package, locate these files in the folder Editor, Vuforia, and then the name of your dataset. The preview model of the scanned area is added automatically to the area target, but a prefab can also be placed in the scene if you want to modify certain captured elements of the area. This preview model is for the purpose of visualization of authoring, occlusion rendering, and simulation mode. Another note, changing the size of the area target game object isn't supported. This guarantees that your scanned real environment contains its original scale throughout the entire development workflow. If you need to use a different scene scale in your project, please review the virtual scene scale factor over in the developer portal. You can find a link to that in the description as well. While placing your 3D objects, you can enable occlusion on your real environment by using the 3D model. By ticking the box for Simulate Occlusion, your preview mesh hides the content that is obstructed by the environment's walls and doors when used in play mode. If you wish to test your area target while being able to see all of your content, untick this box. With an occlusion shader on the preview model, selectively hide content behind walls or doors. Use ray casting with a mesh collider to let users place augmented content at runtime, or add a navigation mesh to your scene to guide users around. Now that you've added your area target, let's put some 3D content in it, like this drone, to test it out. Place your own content into the scene and position it in relation to the preview model, matching the scale of the environment. Add your augmentation content as a child of the area target game object. Once you've placed all your digital content down within your area target, you can preview the experience in simulator mode. Simulator mode is located in Vuforia configuration under play mode. Set up your preferences for walking speed and key bindings and press the play button. This allows you to navigate through your environment while at your computer, providing you with a full preview of your experience to test your effects and interactive components. When you're ready, you can build your Unity project to your AR Core or AR Kit supported device, or to a HoloLens for testing. A Vuforia Engine project is built in the same way as other Unity apps for Android, iOS, and UWP platforms. And here's the result of the area target we've been working on. As you can see, area targets track the entire scanned space, keeping your augmentation stable and allowing for a completely immersive experience. Thanks everyone for attending our Unite Now session. If you want to learn more about area targets or other Vuforia Engine features and functionality, please visit our developer portal. If you have any questions or want to share your finished experiences with us, head on over to the community forums.